When you first hear the word diet, you may think about eating salads, eating chicken breasts, lowering your body weight, lowering your cholesterol, getting jacked, basically getting healthier. But are diets actually healthy for you? We're going to get a little bit more into that, and also we're going to dive into some questions that's going to help us further refine our answer to whether diets are healthy or not, coming up. The answer is, it depends. Obviously, diets do have positive health impacts. That's why healthcare professionals do recommend them to their patients. However, if diets are taken to an extreme and there's no intention in how it's being done, then we can start crossing into the unhealthy territory. Before we go deeper into this conversation, I think that it's going to be very important for us to define what a diet is. For the purposes of what we're talking about here, a diet is a way of eating that's going to promote weight loss. Ultimately, that's going to involve some level of self-control and self-restraint in order to lower the total amount of calories that we eat on a normal basis. Now that we're on the same page of what a diet is, let's get into some clarifying questions to determine when a diet is healthy and when it is not. The first question is, where is your starting point? If you know that you've got poor health markers, if you've got very high body fat, high cholesterol, high blood pressure, maybe you're pre-diabetic, or maybe you're taking medications for any of these conditions that I just listed, then probably going on a diet is going to have healthy benefits for you. At that starting point, some level of dietary adjustment has to be made, otherwise those conditions are only going to get worse. It's rare for someone to reach that level of poor health without having some sort of underlying condition behaviors that they're doing on a normal basis that are contributing to it. In that case, a diet can correct some of those behaviors that can lead to better health results. If your starting point is completely healthy, meaning that you just walked out of your physical and the doctor says that nothing is wrong with you, everything looks like it's okay, then it's kind of questionable whether you should be going on a diet or not. If you fall under that category, if that's your starting point, then be intentional about why you're going on a diet. Be sure to weigh out the pros and cons, consider all the sacrifices that you would need to make during the process, and if the results that you're looking for are going to be worth it. There are very good reasons for going on a diet, even if you're healthy. Maybe you just want to trim a little bit of body fat, look a little bit better, fit into your clothes a little bit better. Or maybe it's because you want to tighten up on your eating behaviors because you think that you might be slipping a little bit, or you may just want to enhance your longevity. All of those things are perfectly fine reasons and rationales for going on a diet and cleaning up your eating behaviors. The thing that I would recommend is to be intentional and be clear about what your reasons are for going on a diet. The second question is, what kind of diet is it? Is it the kind of diet that's going to provide you with a lot of nutrients, that's going to give you good amounts of protein, good amounts of fiber, carbs, healthy fats, as well as the amount of calories that you would need in order to sustain the energy that you need on a day-to-day basis? Is it also going to be a diet that's going to be flexible and gives you the room and the option to eat foods that you are already familiar with? If your answer is yes to those questions, then you're probably following a diet that's pretty healthy for you and that you can sustain for a long period of time. On the other hand, is your diet depriving you of what you need in order to live a good life? Is it too restrictive? Is it starving you? Are you doing some type of crash diet, some type of juice fast, excessive fasting, some type of cleanse, or any other type of fad? Is it non-strategic? Is it kind of like a shotgun approach to get the best results that you can get in the shortest amount of time? If that is so, then you're probably following a diet that is not healthy for you. In addition to that, if you have a diet that is taking too much of your time, if there's just a high level of skill and a high level of knowledge that you are currently not suited for, right? If you've got to follow a lot of rules, then that diet may not be the healthy one for you at this moment. Examples of diets that are high skill, high knowledge, and high effort include keto, vegan, paleo. These diets, they have very specific rules, and they also potentially eliminate huge groups of food that to someone who is completely new to healthy eating, these diets may just be way too overwhelming and it may take over their lives. Not saying that they can't go on those diets, but a more gradual approach is probably going to be the healthier one. Third question is, what's your attitude towards it? If you're thinking, oh, I gotta go on this diet, it's going to suck, chicken breast, broccoli, ugh, God, I'm gonna throw up after each meal, it's gonna be terrible, no flavor involved or anything like that, but I gotta go on this diet because I'm fat, I feel disgusting, I can't look in the mirror, I hate the way that I look, and also, if I don't go on this diet, then no one's ever gonna love me, no one's going to accept me, so I have to do it, I just have to go through it and, you know, just cut my losses and just trudge through the entire thing. If you're going into a diet expecting that it's going to be terrible, that it's going to suck, and it's purely motivated by self-hatred, hating the way that you look, hating the way that you feel, and if it's also based on trying to gain acceptance and external validation from other people, then a diet is probably not going to solve the core main issues that are underlying your need for going on one. The diet and the weight loss may not really solve the issues of self-hatred or the issue of feeling unlovable. In fact, the diet may actually worsen those issues. If you fall into that category, then a diet may be the last thing that you need right now. Perhaps a better starting point is to talk to a good friend or maybe a family member or to a mental health professional about some of the things that you're going through. On the other hand, if you feel excited about feeling better physically, if you feel excited about having better energy levels and better focus throughout the day, if you're excited to eat better, if you're excited to take control of your eating behaviors, then dieting is probably going to be a very positive experience for you. If you're going into a diet expecting that it's going to empower you, that it's going to make you feel better, that it's going to make you look better, and it's going to help you live longer and live a higher quality of life, then this is going to be a great experience for you. Dieting is going to be completely healthy, and it's going to amplify your day-to-day experience. My overall thoughts on all of this is that dieting can be healthy and it can be unhealthy. It all depends on the context. If dieting is done to the extremes with no plan, no strategy, and it's purely dominated by negative emotions, then obviously dieting in that case, in that context, is going to be unhealthy. However, if dieting is done intentionally, if there's a plan, if there's a strategy, if there are appropriate changes and habits that are being undertaken that's aligning to the current skill level of the person who's dieting, if it's not too overwhelming, if it's flexible, if it allows people to have familiar food choices, and if there are positive expectations throughout this entire experience, then dieting is going to be a very, very healthy thing to do. So I want to know what you guys think. Is dieting healthy or unhealthy? Leave your answers in the comments down below. Also, if you have any questions about anything that I said in this video, then please leave those questions in the comments down below as well. If you found value out of this video, if you learned something new, then please consider subscribing to my channel and also liking this video. And also check out the videos on the next screen for more content just like this. And I will see you in the next video. Peace.